Now, government through the Finance Ministry has established a Forex Development Committee that will look into policy measures and interventions to prevent the recurring depreciation of the cedi from assuming the impacts of the central bank. The move follows a promise made by the Finance Minister, Ken Oforiatta, last year that government would establish a bipartisan committee to investigate the structural causes of the cedi depreciation and propose adequate measures. Opinions are divided on the importance of this committee. Member of the committee, Franklin Kujo, has been speaking to my colleague, Kojo Yangsing, on their mandate.
Thank you very much. I would have loved the Secretariat, the Finance Ministry, to be doing this, but I can understand. And I actually understand the consternation that has been expressed, not just facially, but through words as well, and almost the satirical aspects of it as well. At the mention of this committee, and precisely so, because the politicians have politicized the issues of the currency. So any semblance of a committee of persons, however eminent, however noble, however disorderly, that have been put together to do something about, understand any aspects of it, could be termed to be probably a superfluous committee. And that, like the famous words of Ross Perot, if you see a snake, kill it, and don't set up committees. Mm-hmm. But the sole reason why some of us accepted, in fact, my team agreed that I should represent the institution on it, is because we understood the terms of reference quite clearly, and that this is not a parallel body, independent body, to usurp the mandate of the Central Bank of Ghana. In fact, the Central Bank has a more powerful representative on the committee, and we've made that clear. I remember during the inauguration, the Deputy Minister made that clear. I also made it clear as well that if anything of the sort were to happen, then it would have deviated from the purpose. But the main reason why the committee, we joined the committee, was because there was an understanding that the transparency needed in the management of currency flows was not enough, which actually meant that looking at the informal sector of that part of the conversation was useful. So for instance, I mean, if the country reported, in a hypothetical sense, reported a $10 billion receipt, officially reported, but actually we could record just $7 billion. And not that the $3 billion was stolen by a group of people working in tandem to do that, but simply because there are avenues that these things are being externalized and we are not recording properly. It's important to understand that. So Guta, for instance, is there, because they are the last layer that actually interface with our international trading community. Are there persons who know that they are engaging in trading and using physical cash? What could be done about it? Should we interest ourselves in traveler's checks? Because a plane load from Ghana to Asia each time, according to my good friend lawyer Fosu Dothi, carried not less than $300,000 on that plane. With the hindsight of international payments systems, it could be useful that we are doing this and settling payments in our own currency, so that we do not, you know, as it were, carry a lot from here outside as well. So to understand, not just sit at your desk and say, well, I'm the central bank and I'm clothed with the power to intervene in the economy, and at least to do currency management and to ensure that the volatility of the cedi doesn't go wayward. There's some understanding that this committee of people who are mostly deal with Forex. I mean, probably I'm the only one as an institution, and I understand the reason, because we deal in this policy space. Mm-hmm. But almost everybody on that committee deals with Forex, the Seaboard, Chamber of Bulk Oil Distributors, who through their own actions informally had actually saved the economy $1 billion. So they have knowledge, which could be useful to the committee. You understand, Guta has a lot of knowledge to help the committee. I think, for instance, that if the minister, if the government says they have embarked on the paperless POS systems and revenues are being recorded, because a couple of days ago they said there's a 3.2% increase over the last year's revenues. Well, that may seem noble. I believe they could have gotten more had they not embarked on this fishing expedition of revising the benchmark values at the ports for certain goods which were useful, but it's now being bastardized and abused, and the government is losing critical revenue, critical currency that could help shore up its reserves. I should be able to tell the vice president this, or tell the committee, that the finance minister, that, well, you see, while you are trying to do this, there are aspects of your policies that are not helping. This is not something I suspect the Bank of Ghana may know, but it's not really within their remit. I would have to interface with traders to find out this useful information. Or when the Greek minister says that, well, look, we've been bleeding a lot because of our staples. Some of them could be localized here and then substituted here rather, because you're losing $1.5 billion every year to that. That's useful. There's something he wants to do about it. But I'll say to him, or say to the government, but you had the perfect opportunity to change that surgically through your one district, one factory business. Instead of spreading the factories like toffees across the place and wasting critical startup capital, why don't you surgically approach the issue? And thereby doing so, you'd have been helping the currency flow issues. Whether all of this is known is another matter. Mm. But certainly, there is some space for this type of, and I'm a student of how governments can make the life of its independent bodies a hell. And truly, if the God understanding that the Bank of Ghana's powers were going to be usurped, there was no way of being part of the committee. In fact, if the Bank of Ghana rep had not shown up that day as part of the inauguration and made statements as well to the effect that their powers are not being usurped, I probably wouldn't have joined as well. So